Hey, this is Brian Alvarez.
And Filthy Tom Waller here with my... Wait, we should have said that first. I should introduce us into the show.
What better team to introduce Botchmania than the worst fucking tag team of all time? The Chop and Roll Express. Never won a match together as a team. We could only win when we were apart. But today we're together here to introduce Botchmania.
Quite frankly, two bad wrestlers know a bad video when they see one. And Botchmania is the worst.
You wanna play 21?
We got it for you, nigga!
Rudolph!
Jesus! Jeff Harvey!
I've been in the danger zone!
Yeah. Minus 5 stars!
How much is the Skyway?
Oh, God.
I don't know!
Look at the adjective!
A little while ago... Hey, go fuck yourself. Get that guy out of here. Piece of shit.
Well, he ain't changed much.
Oh! He's creating so much space. What is he doing?
A kill on the top. Oh, my God, the kill. What in the crowd?
He's in the front row. That's where Christ's admission.
Oh, good. She's okay. Okay. Big hug.
Talk about being part of the action. Look at this. With such elevation and force.
Did enough damage to Macklin. And now Miguel back in pursuit of his opponent.
1 second. Get him, monster! That's my monster!
Mono D'Lo!
I ain't bring nothing to the table when I'm the table.
Jesus! Huh? What do you mean, what happened? What, are you blind?
Wednesday, we're gonna beat y'all's ass.
Malachi,
Brody, if violence is what you want, we'll take a good lard look, because the Varsity Blondes are not afraid of a little lard.
Can Rhea Ripley stay focused on the task at hand, or will she go after Nikki A.S.H., which she just did?
Tamina trying to avoid contact, and Rhea Ripley got her anyway.
Oh, yeah, yep, they got it.
E-M-M-E-N-T-L, Edmonton!
Wow!
Okay.
That is correct.
There's no surprise to me that the Inner Circle got Faction of the Year, because since day one in AEW, our mission statement has never wavered. We promised to take over this country, to dominate this company and this country and this world.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is our honor to welcome back for the first time in nearly 20 years on SmackDown. For the first time in nearly 20 years on SmackDown, it is my honor to welcome to SmackDown for the first time in nearly 20 years, Lita!
With respect, you are wrong.
You know, most days, I would say I am fully satisfied with my career. Until kind of recently, right? I did not have the opportunity to compete in the Royal Rumble match when I was competing. We didn't have one. But now we do. And I don't know about you guys, but
that paperwork.
That's cap. Totally cap. That means lie.
Hey, so we, on the other side with the Dark Order, you have 5 and 10. You know why 6 is afraid of 7.
Because 8, 9, 8, 9.
You're the worst. Because 7, 8, 9.
That was it. I knew that 7. And
you're
that's so
horrible at math.
I'm a product of the New York City public school system, my friend.
PSFTW. Once again.
Jeez.
In Davis, California, the next night, it's a Raw taping. Meltzer would write, Jarrett and Windham beat LOD in a weird match. The match was boring with Morton, Gibson, and Cornette in the corner. Animal was hit by Windham with the tennis racket while Morton and Gibson were fighting with Hawk, and then they pinned him. The bell rang and they were announced as the winners, although apparently it was a screw up as everyone acted weird and just kept wrestling looking mad. What do you remember about this match and why it was different?
I remember this for sure, Conrad. I don't know why, but my God, it was a stinker. I mean, it was scrambled eggs. They didn't want to beat anybody. I don't know the politics behind it, but it was not good.
So the match gets edited to hell. It cuts off at the pinfall. We don't ever see the DQ. So thank goodness it was taped.
Seamless, huh? You're fired.
Scrambled eggs.
Cesaro is outside of his office. We're going to go talk to him.
Where is the world heavyweight champion? You look agitated about this. What is on your mind, Cesaro?
What is on my mind, Emilio? You want to know what is on my mind?
Enhance. El Jefe, talk to me, boss man. Where is the world heavyweight champion? You look agitated about this. What is on your mind, Cesaro?
Is he nuts?
a good sign. Now that's a good sign. What the fuck is that?
You can't get him! You can't get him! You can't get him! You can't get him!
Botchamania.
Ah, at last, as it should be, you and I to the death. You talk too much.
You want a mic check? This is Vince McMahon back with Jesse the Body Ventura.
This is Jesse Ventura, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
One away. 10-second throw back to Mean Gene with the Twin Towers.
Good, thank you.
I can't read this. The light is the shits. Of course, I need my cheaters, I guess.
You got like a bag of laundry, Tony.
Got you, man.
Laundry man. Pop myself on that one. Shut up. Having fun right now.
Oh, didn't see you come in. I'm Bennett the Sage. You may remember me as a nondescript asshole in any one of the Channel Awesome movies. But today I'm here to read to you from Eddie Guerrero's autobiography, Cheating Death, Stealing Life. So please, sit back, relax, and enjoy my sonorous and dulcet tones. Russo and Ferrara were under the misconception that gimmicks and bad comedy vignettes were the answer to WCW's problems. Nitro became even more of a mess than it had been in Bischoff's final days as Russo and Ferrara tried to pop ratings with an endless series of stupid angles, swerves, and what they thought wrestling fans wanted to see most, gimmick matches. For whatever reason, these guys were total marks for a pole match. They'd put anything on top of a pole. Pinatas, brass knuckles, a crowbar, a leather jacket, Buff Bagwell's mother. My personal pole match fiasco had the Revolution locking Billy Kidman's girlfriend, Tori Wilson, in a shark cage. Then Perry Saturn challenged me to a match, and the key to the cage on top of the pole. I was supposed to save Tori by grabbing the key and winning the match, but the finish was a total mess. I had put on too much baby oil before the match, and the combination of baby oil and sweat all over my arms and chest made it impossible to climb up the damn pole. Every time I tried to get up there, whoosh! I'd slide right down. Ah, shit, I thought. What am I going to do now? The other filthy animals started panicking and tried to help me. I pushed Conan off. Don't worry, I've got it. I unintentionally pie-faced Billy Kidman. Fuck off, I can do it. Finally, I leapt for the key and thank God I didn't miss. I would have been so screwed. That was one of those do-or-die moments when you do whatever it takes to make the match work. I left WCW after Thanksgiving. Little knowing that I wouldn't have to worry about Russo and Ferrara, or WCW for much longer. Thank you for joining me on this special occasion. If you enjoy my voice, or you want to see more of me, you can check me out here on YouTube. Just type in Bennett the Sage or Anime Abandon. I'm sure you'll find me. Oh, by the way, if you're wondering where Matthew found that fucking bullshit song, I was the one who introduced him to it. You're welcome.
Big reaction right here, Excalibur. I mean,
fudge.
We've got Hook.
I like that Snoop Dogg figure up there.
Hey, Hook, did you find what you were looking for?
I left empty-handed. I was looking at that Snoop figure, but I could think of better places to put my $150.
2 hours later.
Mm-hmm.
tongue, my new name is Gunther. That's right. Gunther, get your fucking head kicked in.
You're gonna get your fucking head kicked in. You're gonna get your fucking head kicked in.
All right, we're almost out of here. Now, from here on, it gets pretty normal. Offices, storerooms, a nice false front. I count to three.
Hello, if I want you.
I open that door, and we move out.
Everybody got that.
Ready? Follow the leader. One, two, three. We may be trapped.
Nothing can keep me from focusing on my duty, except for one thing. A crippling obsession with large breasts.
Going to shock the world because he is none other than the Shock Master!
Rock!
That never happened, did it, Vince?
The two of you will fight, and it'll be pretty even.
Not for long.
Yeah, you'll use that special move you keep talking about and really let him have it. That'll piss him off, and suddenly it's, whoops, here comes his latent powers, I didn't see that coming.
What?
Your last thoughts before being dissolved into powder will be...
Impossible!
Exactly.
How could you be so certain? He could be another peasant chump with a black belt.
Or a lucky drunk.
Or maybe an aggressive salesperson.
It's the hair. They always have spiky hair.
The winner! Of this match is Gunther!
Lieben, glauben, loben.
Give it to me, baby!
Send Hook!
Hey, Mr. Burns, did you get that letter I sent?
Letter? I don't recall any letter.
That's because I forgot to stamp.
Gotcha. Oh, that kid slays me.
It was early last September, as near as I can remember, while strolling down the lane in Pipsy Pride. Not a word did I utter as I lay down in the gutter. And this pig came up and lay down by my side. Not a soul was I disturbing as I lay down by the curbing. When this high-toned lady came, I heard her say, "You can tell a man who boozes by the company he chooses." And a pig got up and slowly walked away.
I'm a man of few words, but a man of many riddles. So riddle me this. What is it that is always coming but never arrives?
Quickly, quickly.
We ain't tuned in on the riddle bit, Chief.
Yeah! We give up. What is it that is always coming but never arrives?
Fucking bullshit! Son of a bitch!
Bullshit, Uncle Gunn!